Certain things you just can't refuse. She wanna ride like a cruise, and I'm not trying to lose. Then you're left in the dust, unless I stuck by ya. You're a sunflower, I think your love would be too much.
Good morning, NBHS. I'm Ant Puglisi.
And I'm Nick Baer. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. As the old saying goes, new year, new me. We have some great resolutions to hear about from our very own NBHS students. Nick Baer was able to get insight on what each of you are working towards.
Winter's upon us, new year's just passed. It's 2019, let's go check out some New Year's resolutions. Some great resolutions are to work out and make it a goal to be healthier. We even have a friendly competition going on with a few seniors.
My New Year's resolution was to hit the gym, get buff, you know, pump some iron, baby, yeah, yeah.
My New Year's resolution is to be bigger than Lou. He's pretty small, so I think it should be pretty easy.
My New Year's resolution is to become stronger than Nick Biancini.
My New Year's resolution is to be bigger than Nick, Issa, and Lou because they're all small.
Some goals that will get accomplished by other students, whether it's a competition or not, are...
My New Year's resolution is to work out more because apparently pizza isn't good for you.
My New Year's resolution this year is to get better grades and just be more responsible.
My New Year's resolution is to get better grades than last year.
My New Year's resolution is to be more like Bray Dayutai.
My New Year's resolution is to use my phone less and to read more books.
Everybody's working hard to get that new year started right. Hope you are too. I'm Nick Baer reporting TBird News.
Many students participate in high school sports, but none stand out like Allie Lager. Pat was able to talk to the Boston College commit star and see how she felt about her recent accomplishments and get to know a little more about her.
Good morning, North Brantford. Welcome to this year's first edition of Student Spotlight. I'm Pat Mycone. And today, I'm here with Allie Auger, a member of our girls' soccer team, an All-American, and a Boston College commit. How you doing, Al?
I'm good.
All right, Allie, so I'm here today to ask you a few questions, not only about soccer, but also about a few other things. You ready?
Yep.
All right. My first question, what's a tradition that you do before every soccer game?
Definitely listening to music and just kind of getting into the mindset of game time. I think that's a huge thing, especially for athletes.
Who do you think was your biggest competition overall in North Brantford soccer?
I'd probably have to say Old Lyme. They're always a tough battle and it's kind of a rivalry, especially since we had beat them last year in the Shoreline Championship.
If you weren't a goalie, what position do you think you'd play in soccer?
Probably a forward. Before I was goalie, I was forward and midfield, so.
What do you think it means to be an All-American?
I'm extremely humbled and blessed to have been honored with such a prestigious award, and I honestly can't believe it, but I really owe it to my teammates and my coaches, so.
In regards to the Powder Puff game, which team do you think was the hardest and why?
Probably the juniors, just because that upperclassman rivalry, but of course seniors came out on top, so.
All right, and what's your most memorable soccer game in North Brantford?
I'd have to say last year, the Shoreline Championship game, of course, it was amazing to, take home a trophy after 10 years, and so it was amazing experience.
Thank you, Allie. Now with those questions out of the way, I'd like to change to a different segment. This segment's called Lights, Camera, Action. I'm gonna give you a quick question and you're gonna give me the fastest response you can.
Okay.
All right? All right, my first question. Why did you choose BC?
I love the campus and the team and it just felt right.
What's the best advice you've ever been given?
To work your hardest and to never give up.
What's your favorite part about the town of North Brantford?
The close-knit community and everyone's always there for each other.
What's your favorite sport other than soccer?
Probably basketball.
if you weren't going to Boston College, which school would you pick?
Yale.
All right, this one's a weird one. If you were on an island and you could only bring one person with you, who would you bring?
Probably my sister, Gabby.
What's the best pizza place in town?
Bobby's all the way.
That concludes this edition of Student Spotlight. I'd like to thank Allie for being here, and I will see you in the halls.
As midterms came to an end, some new classes began for students, and they are really looking forward to what is in store for them the second half of the year. I was able to go around the school and see what courses students are taking.
With the midterms over and the start of a new semester, students are looking forward to their new classes. Let's see what they're looking forward to.
Many people are excited for their new classes this upcoming semester. This also included Mr. Steffler, who had much to say about what's going on forward here at NBHS.
Well, NBHS, exams have just finished up, and that wraps up the first semester. We're looking for the second semester, and as you know, things move very quickly. We're in the midst of our winter sports season. You have the spring musical underway with practice and rehearsals, and the spring will be here very shortly. For our seniors in particular, our seniors will be making some hard decisions over the next few months about where they're going to attend, what financial package they will accept for those colleges, and we're looking forward to everybody being safe and have a productive second semester at NBHS.
I'm looking forward to taking consumer economics because that's something I could actually use in my life, and that's dope.
I'm also looking forward to consumer ec because I'll be able to learn how to plan for the future.
So for the new year, I'm looking forward to starting a new class this semester, Intro to Soc, which sounds interesting, and hopefully it's fun.
I'm looking forward to taking Media Lit next semester.
We're halfway there, North Brantford. New semester starting up, and a lot of events are going to be happening, as well as students being able to broaden their horizon into new classes.
As you can see, students are really looking forward to their new classes for their upcoming semester. For TBird News, I'm Ed Puglisi.
Back in December, a bunch of schools were able to come down to our auditorium to participate in the annual SHED conference. Kai Stone was able to get the inside scoop and see what went down.
As you know, NBHS has a bunch of cool writers who wish to pursue it as a future career. A great way to bring it together is the SHED Writing Conference. I attended a few workshops to write this story.
During the fall semester, our school, alongside nine others, participated in the SHED Writing Conference, where local writers taught students a particular field of writing via workshops.
I wish you could stand here and watch what I watched.
This event was organized by Ms. Dodds, who detailed what went on.
I find local writers who specialize in fiction, poetry, creative nonfiction, journalism, and songwriting. A lot of the writers are current or former students at Southern Connecticut State University in their Master of Fine Arts program for creative writing, and some of them are people that I know from student teaching or college. I popped into each of the workshops for a few minutes. They all seemed really fun. I wish I could just attend all of them for the whole time. The most popular ones are usually the fiction workshops. Those fill up the quickest. I went to a couple poetry workshops that were really awesome as well, and the entertainment journalism one is always a lot of fun.
The in-school field trip was successful and gave students an opportunity to work on their particular writing goal. Nate Gildersleeve briefly spoke about his experiences, the workshops he attended.
The workshops that I attended were fictionalizing your story, which is telling your life story from a different person's perspective and telling your downfalls throughout your life and your uprise. And the other workshop that I attended was a poetry one, which we did chain poetry. The person I had gave us words, and we had to put them together to make a poem. These two workshops did help me with my writing goal. It helped me become a better writer itself, and it made me come up with new ideas with my writing. Like for poetry, I can see more detail in my writing now than I have ever before, and a lot of people keep pointing that out to me.
Wow, what an awesome experience it was to be with such talented writers from different schools. Hopefully, we all learned something from this day and use it in our future careers. Reporting for TBird News, I'm Kai Stone.
That's it for this episode of TBird News. Good luck on your New Year's resolutions and classes. Make sure you follow us on Twitter and subscribe to our YouTube channel. I'm Nick Barrett.
And I'm Ant Puglisi. See you guys next time.
Every time I'm leaving on you, you don't make it easy, no. Wish I could be there for you. Give me a reason to. Every time I'm walking out, I can hear you telling me to turn around.